in this particular case, the EU needs to be a bit more adaptive and to do it not on its own, because it has done quite well in developing the whole machinery of cooperation with the neighbourhood, but it needs to do it with the partner countries, with the neighbours. It needs to connect better with them, but also think in a wider geostrategic context. And one of the most important priorities, in my opinion, would include, for example, for the EU to continue developing its differentiated approach. For example, it proved that it can work in Belarus at low political level, at more sort of a technocratic engagement, which actually will some positive results. It needs to develop more partnership with the countries in the neighborhood to increase their stake in the whole process of decision making, but also implementation. I think it also needs to be a bit more visible there in the neighborhood, because after all, success stories would only inspire and increase partners' commitment to the process. Also, I think it is very important for the EU to try and develop more integrated approach. After all, now we're dealing with a myriad of instruments, with a myriad of actors, both in the EU and also across the neighbourhood. And I think connecting them, centralising them and consolidating the EU approach, I think would actually make the effort much, much greater. And finally, I think we should be a bit more dissented in our working with the neighbours. Dissented in the sense that we can only reform the system from within. With all our know-how, with all our knowledge, we can only transfer knowledge, but they need to learn to implement it. And I think this is perhaps one of the most greatest, biggest challenges for the neighborhood. Regional cooperation, in my opinion, is absolutely essential, because not only it allows for the for sharing best practices across the region, because after all, each country could develop their particular know-how, but also they can share their experience as to what could work better and what doesn't work at all. But also, I think it is important, this regional cooperation, in terms of in terms of allowing countries to develop their own individual niche, to develop their own identity, so that they know exactly where they stand in the region and what their particular place in the region is. But also, working jointly would actually increase their sense of community. And as community, they would become far stronger. It would empower them, for example, to withstand whatever challenges, geostrategical challenges, might be out there on both sides of the neighbourhood. And finally, I think collective learning, group learning, is always far more beneficial than learning it alone. Because after all, it's the collective knowledge that makes us greater.